Welcome to Williams Around the Way. My name is Tonya Richardson. I'm the Public Relations Officer for Mayor Dennis P. Williams and the City of Wilmington. We're here every second and fourth Sunday to share with the community issues and projects that are going on that we think are important to share in a little more depth than usual. Today, I'll be sharing some updates from the last few weeks, and then I'll have new administration member Shefon Taylor, who has joined the Cultural Affairs Department, to talk about perennial favorite Art Loop, or Art on the Town. But to start, let me just share some important projects that have been happening over the past few weeks. Yesterday, Mayor Dennis P. Williams joined with the community, civic partners, and elected officials to unveil renditions of the planned Wilmington Skate and Wellness Plaza. The Skate Jam event included a family-friendly environment where stakeholders and members of local and regional skateboard communities came to look at the first pictures of what's being planned for the Skate Plaza. And I have some pictures that I can show while I tell you about it. The concept of the skate park was envisioned over 15 years ago, and the mayor is very proud that our city and state are at a place where we can finally put plans into action. Over the past 2 years, the Department of Planning and Development, led by Director Leonard Soffren, have been coordinating efforts for the plaza's development from the ground up. You'll see here in these pictures that this is a space that is widely considered unused. Some people might say unsafe, but you'll see in the renderings upcoming that the event was really designed to help us envision what will happen when the skate park is finished. There will be significant square footage to encourage exercise of all kinds, such as walking, running, and open spaces for individual and group exercise. And the skating area itself will include a transition, bowl, and street elements. The park is planned for the vicinity of 300 Liberty Street, which is an unused space under I-95, under the I-95 exit to MLK Boulevard. Nationally acclaimed Grindline Skate Park Design and Construction out of Seattle, Washington, has been brought on board and provided the renderings meeting the required specifications. This firm has built skate parks from around the country, including Payne Park in Philadelphia and smaller projects such as the parks in Newark, Delaware. Anthony Santoro of Wilmington Skate Project has been involved in the project since 2008 and shared at yesterday's gathering that the skateboarding community is universal and cross-generational, and that this space will invite people from all different skill levels to enjoy a sport that has really grown to a place that most people probably would not even imagine. The completion of this project will provide another park to the city's stock of recreational offerings, which already includes spaces for basketball, baseball, tennis, swimming, and walking. Now we can add skateboarding to the roster. Wilmington is in a unique position as most skate parks are funded by the community at the grassroots level. However, $1 million of funding has already been raised publicly by the partners involved, and the planning group is continuing to raise funds to put finishing touches on the project. The project is slated for completion in the summer of 2016. In the meantime, there will be opportunities for more sponsors and individual donors to contribute. Extras such as evening overhead lighting are in our plan, and we know that there are resources in the community to make this full vision a reality. Numerous city partners have been involved, including Representative Helene Keeley, Councilwoman Hanifa Shabazz, Councilwoman Sherry Dorsey Walker, the Delaware Department of National Resources and Environmental Control, known as DENREC, Delaware Department of Transportation, Delaware Transit Corporation, Downtown Visions, Kinetic Skateboarding, and of course the Wilmington Skate Project. This past week, Mayor Williams joined state, county, and city officials to announce the redevelopment of the historic Harper Thiel site into a boutique shopping plaza. Among partners in attendance were Deputy Secretary Kara Coates of the Delaware Department of National Resources and Environmental Control, Ralph Pepe, who is the founder of Concordia Holding. Harper Thiel is a well-known landmark in the northwest section of the city. It's a 2.3-acre brownfield parcel located at 3101 Miller Road. Many Delawareans and Wilmingtonians will recognize this as the currently abandoned and vacant space across from Haynes Park on Miller Road. The site's now poised for redevelopment through a partnership and collaborative efforts between the Wilmington Urban Development Action Grant Corporation, known as UDAG, the City Office of Economic Development, the Department of National Resources and Environmental Control, again DENREC, and Concordia Holding. The project aims to establish the Ninth Ward community as a more walkable and pedestrian-friendly neighborhood. Redeveloping Harper Thiel will complement recent transportation enhancements and investments made by DelDOT on Miller Road. Specifically, repaving and restriping of streets have created new traffic patterns and now are more convenient to pedestrians. Harper Thiel has a long history of industrial use that began back when Francis Irene DuPont, the first director of the first experimental station and great-grandson to E.I. DuPont, purchased the land in 1916 and established his own personal laboratory there. From 1946 until 2000, the Harper Thiel Company electroplated materials using chrome, nickel, cadmium, and copper for major clients such as DuPont and the United States Navy. Although the business process was successful, it did contaminate the area. Using the Hazardous Substance Cleanup Act funds of $3 million, Denrec Site Investigation and Remediation Section directed the cleanup of the property. Five buildings and other auxiliary structures were demolished, and about 3,600 tons of contaminated soil were excavated and disposed of safely. The site was owned by Wilmington UDAG, and currently it's under redevelopment by Concordia. Concordia owner Mr. Pepe oversaw the growth and development of a Tallyville Town Shops and has also restored and renovated one of Delaware's oldest historical buildings, the Brandywine Grange number 13. His development and entrepreneurial spirit will positively impact the redevelopment of the Harper Thiel site to become an amenity for the surrounding neighborhood. At the event this week, Mayor Williams shared that for years, members of the community around the Ninth Ward and citywide have advocated for the redevelopment of this historic structure. It will be developed into a mixed-use space that offers key amenities to the neighborhood, maintaining much of the strong historical value. Presently, the site is being stabilized to prepare for construction, which is expected to begin in the spring of 2016. This past week, the City of Wilmington partnered with the Delaware Center for Horticulture and TD Bank in the planting of 30 trees, which were donated as a part of TD Bank's Tree Day effort. To support the city's stormwater management goals and strategic urban forestry plan, DCH partnered with the city's Department of Parks and Recreation to propose the Mats and Run area for the city event. 30 volunteers from TD Bank took part in prepping and planting 6 varieties of trees. Volunteers from BJ's Wholesale Club also supported the effort as a part of their local club for community projects. The event took place at the south end of Matson Run near Washington Street behind the Congregation Beth Emmeth on Lee Boulevard. It's part of National Neighbor Woods Month, celebrating the many benefits of our urban forest in partnership with the National Alliance for Community Trees and the National Arbor Day Foundation. The City of Wilmington's Parks and Recreation Director, James Lane, was joined by David Hardigan of TD Bank and Vikram Krishnamurthy of Delaware Center for Horticulture in the opening ceremony. Park Superintendent Mark Sparagna was on hold to direct volunteers and manage the siting of trees. Jason Gaskill and Adele Meehan, members of the Wilmington Tree Commission, appointed by Mayor Williams, also supported the event on behalf of the city. This is a great example of the role that corporate volunteerism has in the development of our community. And frankly, corporate partnerships have always had a strong presence in the development of Wilmington's neighborhoods. These types of partnerships help us with beautification projects, cleanup projects on an ongoing basis, and there are many, many environmental benefits to corporate partners working with us in this way. We thank TD Bank, BJ's, and DCH, who is a longtime partner with the city. DCH's mission and work and partnership with us make a lot of what we do in neighborhoods possible. So thank you all. Please stay with us over a short break. When I come back, I'll be speaking with Shefon Taylor of Cultural Affairs. Stay with us.
Thank you.
Welcome back and thanks for staying with us. You're watching Williams Around the Way. I'm Tonya Richardson. And in this segment, we'll be speaking with my almost brand new colleague, Shefon Taylor. Shefon and I work together on what we call the MOCA suite of the mayor's office. That stands for the Mayor's Office of Communications and Cultural Affairs. And she's been on board for about maybe 5 or 6 weeks. In the role of really boosting the city's presence on social media and our web presence and our internet presence. And she's here today to talk about her role as our new leader of the Art Loop, also known as Art on the Town. So welcome.
Thank you for inviting me here and on the ninth floor.
We're glad to have you. So each first Friday of the month is something called Art Loop. Why don't we start just by talking about what that is?
Absolutely. So Art in Town, also affectionately known as Art Loop Wilmington, is a free self-guided public art event. And Art Loop Wilmington brings together art lovers and communities to the ever-evolving downtown and greater Wilmington area. So there are art galleries, studios, museums, and also alternative art spaces that offer an opportunity to meet the featured artist, enjoy refreshments, often lots of wine and cheese, and in some cases, even live entertainment. So almost around every corner, you have some very exciting and unique offerings every first Friday of the month from 5 to 9 p.m.
So if I were interested to take part in Art Loop, which is coming up the first Friday in November, mm-hmm. how would I orchestrate my movements?
Absolutely. So as an attendee of the Art Loop, each month Art Loop Wilmington has a section of Out and About magazine. And there is published the 25 plus gallery tour that features information about the exhibits, maps, and also a bus schedule. We want to ensure that there is accessibility to Art Loop Wilmington, so the City of Wilmington does provide transportation on that night. So reviewing those galleries and choosing where you want to go, mapping your Friday night, and then choosing your method of transportation. You can choose to use the transportation that's provided by the city, or you can do it in a self-guided way where you walk or drive mm-hmm. if it gets too cold or it's rainy to the different events on your own.
Nice. What are the types of venues that have gotten involved? Give us an example of the places I might
absolutely
check out.
Yeah, it's a really wide range. So you have like your traditional art spaces like the Delaware Center for Contemporary Arts. You have individual owned galleries, like the new gallery that opened by Miss Eunice. Mm-hmm. And then there are also some spaces that participate that are not traditionally art spaces. You have Loma Coffee, Levity, all of these spaces on the first Friday of the month turn into art galleries, and all of those spaces feature the artists. And then you also have the opportunity to indulge in whatever else is happening, whether it be tea or coffee or food that they sell there. So it's a really great way to have those businesses also participate in the art.
Downtown, Trolley Square, these are parts of the town that just kind of come alive on those Fridays.
Absolutely.
How do venues and artists get involved with Art Loop? If I have a space or I'm an artist and I want to get involved, what should I do?
Absolutely. So we just recently had a call for artists of all genres and artistries to participate in the Art Loop. And they can literally participate by sending an email to artloop@wilmingtonde.gov.
artloop@wilmingtonde.gov,
and submit artwork there. So just a little information about themselves as the artist, what type of art they create, and where they are interested in featuring. So, and as a venue, online, if you go to www.cityfestwilm.com/artloopwilmington, there is a space to submit for the upcoming month's Art Loop. Just fill in information about the venue, about the artist, and there is a $25 contribution that's made to be featured in Out and About magazine. So it's that easy.
Pretty easy.
And then you can also find us on social media. Facebook page is Art in the Town of Wilmington, and Instagram and Twitter are Art Loop Wilmington.
Great. I plan to have you back soon because there's a lot going on in cultural affairs.
Yes.
I know you'll be starting a podcast soon,
yes,
which is really exciting.
Very
for the
exciting
city. So I'd like to have you back to spend more time to talk about what's going on in cultural affairs. For now, thank you so much.
Absolutely. Thank you.
And I'm going to have you stay with me while I sign off. Before we say goodbye for this evening, I want to share a few important announcements with you, neighbors. To begin, plans are being solidified to dedicate a park bench in Rodney Square in honor of Thomas L. Cottingham. Neighbors may remember that Mr. Cottingham gave his life while attempting to rescue a young mother and her baby who were being accosted in Rodney Square. We're planning to have a dedication ceremony on Saturday, November 14th, 2015 at 10 a.m. in Rodney Square. The family's been notified, and there will be remarks by the mayor and members of Mr. Cottingham's family and friends, and the event is open to the public. We'll continue to publicize that over the next several weeks. Also, we'd like to announce that Mayor Williams will be hosting the Mayor's Halloween Party on Saturday, October 31st. That is Halloween Day. The party will be held at Theater Inn and will feature children's Halloween films and a candy giveaway. The party is free to all attendees and, again, will take place from 10 a.m. to 12 noon. All guests, including adults, are encouraged to wear Halloween costumes, and all children must be accompanied by an adult. The event is free, but please RSVP so that we can be prepared for the numbers to attend. And you can do that by calling the mayor's office at 302-576-2100. And our final reminder, as always, walk-in Wednesdays are every Wednesday in the mayor's office. The next walk-in Wednesday, this Wednesday, the 28th, will take place from 4 p.m. to 8 p.m. Please come prepared to fill out a short form, explain your concern or issue, and to wait in line to be seen in the order that you arrive. This has become really popular and very effective way for residents to be heard not only by the mayor, but by other departments in the administration that are often involved in problem solving. We really want to encourage you to use that time to get one-on-one time with the administration. Also a reminder that everything we've talked about here tonight, Art Loop, updates on the skate park in Harper Thiel, are all on our website, which is www.wilmingtonde.gov. You can find updates there, and you can also self-select to receive emails and updates. Just click the envelope at the bottom of the page and give us your email. Thank you so much for joining us for this jam-packed half hour. We'll see you again on November the 8th, which is the second Sunday in November, when we're back with Williams Around the Way. I'm Tonya Richardson. Thanks, and be well.